Dear students, how are you all? Are you feeling okay? All right. Today, we are going to learn a very, very inspiring lesson. It is about the writer Ahluwalia, who was a member of the first successful Indian expedition to Mount Everest. In this lesson, he tells us how he felt while standing on the Mount Everest, the highest summit of the world. He also tells us that the summit within human heart and mind is higher and more difficult to reach than Mount Everest. It means achieving self-realization through knowledge, and as we know, knowledge has no limits. So students, let's start the lesson. The name of the lesson is The Summit Within. The name of the writer is H.P.S. Ahluwalia. The name of the writer is H.P.S. Ahluwalia. According to the writer, mountains throw a challenge to the young and adventurous people. On reaching the summit of Everest, he looked below and his first feeling was that of humility and gratitude to God for his brilliant success. While getting down from the summit in 1965, the writer asked himself some questions. Why did he climb Mount Everest? Why do people climb mountains? The answer is that man takes delight in overcoming obstacles. Secondly, man is adventurous by nature and he has a deep desire to rise above his surroundings. According to the writer, three qualities helped him in his climb. The three qualities are endurance, persistence, and willpower. The three qualities are endurance, persistence, and willpower. Mountains have been a great attraction to the writer since his childhood. According to him, mountains are nature's best creation, most beautiful and majestic. They are a means of communication with God. Again, for the writer, Everest is the highest and the mightiest. The climber has to struggle hard with rock and ice. The climb down is as risky as going up. When the summit is conquered, the climber feels a sense of victory and happiness. Therefore, the writer finds the beauty, challenge, and difficulties of Mount Everest irresistible. Moreover, climbing is 90% hell and 10% beauty. But the fellow climbers proved to be a source of inspiration, and one gets physical, emotional, and spiritual fulfillment and satisfaction. The climbers also remember their gods to feel confident. In the lesson, the writer also mentions the symbols of reverence and respect left by members of the team on Everest. The writer left Guru Nanak's picture on Everest. Rawat left a picture of Goddess Durga. Phu Dorji, another mountaineer, left a relic of Buddha. Hilary had put a cross under a heap of rocks. at the end, the writer says that it is far more difficult to climb the summit within oneself than to climb the summit of a mountain. Each man has within him his own mountain peak. It is fearful and unscalable. Internal summit is perhaps higher than Everest because it can give us a fuller knowledge of ourselves. We can know more about ourselves. We can also experience physical, emotional, and spiritual satisfaction. So, dear students, the lesson gives us inspiration to face life's difficulties, challenges, and problems with courage and determination. Have you understood the lesson? Is it very clear to you?